Hey guys, welcome back to World Mechanics. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. Today will be a super helpful video guys to any of you having a Kia, any Kia vehicle guys, and you're trying to test the camshaft position sensors. Okay, stay with us, we'll explain how to do that. It will work for intake, exhaust camshaft position sensor on most Kia vehicles. We will explain what approach you need to get, what to do, what not to do, because if you don't do it right, you can cause damage to the engine computer of your Kias as well. So that procedure should work on multiple models guys. Okay, multiple models Kias, and we're going to explain how we're going to do it today, so make sure you stay until the end and we're going to cover all that. Also, let me tell you quick about us guys. If you need to buy any parts, tools for your Kia Optima, check out the link in the description of the video below and you can see where we get all our tools and parts from for a really good price and quick shipping as well. Another thing, every single car we get at the garage, we make more than 200 to 300 free repair videos provided to you absolutely free guys. Why we do that? Simply because our mission in the shop is to save you as much money as we can. All we need in return, please subscribe to the channel and like the video. In addition, if you have a Kia Optima guys, okay, this generation, and you want to see more information about electrical components, engine diagnostics, diagnosing airbag, codes, anything like that, all that will be published on our second YouTube channel, Electrical Car Repair Live. Check it out guys, we have so much information that can save you practically thousands of dollars if you have a Kia Optima guys. So, what do you need to do guys? Okay, we'll go inside. You get the key guys, okay, and you need to turn the ignition key to the second position right before you start the engine, but you have the dash lights on. So when you see your engine light on the dash, battery light, all that stuff, means that you're at the correct position. If you have the push start button, don't press the brake pedal, okay, and you will need to, I think, press the start button on some vehicle once, some twice, okay, until we get the dash lights on. Now, we have, okay, that key here, which is a 4-cylinder engine, but even if you have a 6-cylinder, the procedure will be about the same. For instance, the 4-cylinder engine has two camshafts, guys, one on the intake side, one on the exhaust side. This is where the intake camshaft position sensor is supposed to stay, but we removed it so we can show you how to test it, okay, right here. And then we have the exhaust side, okay, over there. How do you guys test those things? Okay, let's explain that now. You're going to need, guys, okay, a voltmeter. Set it at 20 volts, okay, 20 volts. This is the connector for the camshaft position sensor. Okay, this is the connector for the camshaft position sensor. So, now, right here, guys, okay, that connector consists of three wires most of the times if you have that design. Now, how you're going to find out, okay, which wires you need for the testing? We're going to put the black on the very left side. Let's put on the left side black. And red, okay, in the middle. That's what we usually do. Then we get negative 12 numbers. So we need to switch. If you have a negative number, switch the probes. What do we have now? Negative 12. Okay, positive 12. That's the battery wire, guys. That's the battery voltage in the vehicle. That's great. Now, we need to switch the red one to the other side. And we're going to get 4.8. That means, guys, that the middle wire is ground. And now the one on the right side is known as a signal wire. If you have around 5 volts, the one on the left side in our case will be the battery wire. The covers on the back, okay, ground in our case will be green. Blue with orange will be actually signal wire. Some of the vehicles will differ, but that's how you find out which wires you need. Now, you need to get the sensor, guys. You go ahead, plug it in. Okay, plug it in until it clicks. Perfect. You can even turn the ignition off when you do that, just for safety. So, now, through the back side, through the seal, you can push the probes inside, and it's going to tell you, okay, you need to get about 4.8 volts on the signal wire with the ground wire. Perfect. Just like that. Let me just tilt it a little bit that way so I can show you what I'll be doing. Perfect. Just like that. Now, if you get, guys, a metal tool, okay, get it close to that camshaft position sensor, the reading should go to zero. That's how it detects the camshaft. When the camshaft comes at a certain position, it has a high spot that it's metal, and camshaft sensor detects it, guys. So it's pretty much on and off switch. It's going to interrupt the signal wire to the engine computer. So check it out now. If I get close, zero. I come up, 4.8. Get close, zero. Come up, 4.8. And you can see this is a good working sensor. If yours doesn't change or it's stuck, that means that the camshaft sensor is not working correctly. You may even have, guys, okay, you may even have a bad fuse somewhere. Okay, I need to, okay, we don't, Okay, perfect. You just need to get the spot where the magnet is, guys. You kind of like feel it. Okay, perfect. You can see, because if I come a little bit sideways, it doesn't work. It's like a magnet, it pulls the metal, so that's great working sensor there as well. Now, make sure you don't touch the two wires together with the probes, because you can burn fuse for the camshaft sensor, or you can even cause damage to your engine computer. Hopefully, guys, the video will be helpful to any of you trying to figure this thing out. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.